My question is very simple. Why waking up to go to work, it's way much more difficult than waking up to go to work. Definitely more fun.
I absolutely guess that it's not fun for them either way.
Essential guys, coffee.
I want American.
You are the Tundra owner, right?
Yeah.
How is it to drive a Tundra?
Love it.
You love it. You spent some good identification on the cars, I guess so, right?
Yeah.
So now, any advice for people who drive a desert?
Deflate your tires before you get in.
Deflate the tires. What else? What's the biggest challenge you face?
I drive a Tundra, so I don't have the challenge of power. It's a lot of fun.
Let's see what the Jeep owner says. Look at the Jeep. Look at Jeepers. There's one thing you need to know about Jeepers, guys, that they always stick together. You see them here. They always drive together and stick together, right? So any advice? Expensive, $392.
No, it's a Jeep way first. That to all the Jeepers, and there is only one. It go fast and goes anywhere now. It's a new statement.
And spends a lot of money on gasoline. Professional desert driver. Any advice for new people driving the desert?
Well, I would suggest go easy in the beginning, because you might think that the machine is very powerful and it can make you do a lot of things, but you need to have the experience before you conquer.
That's right. Safety comes first, my brother. I'm gonna show you the cars in a bit. So let me show you the cars that we're gonna be trying today. We have this Tundra. Pretty cool ride. You see this Ford Tundra, guys. How far you can go with the Tundra, you see that? Now this one is a custom made. Pretty beautiful, it has a bunch of modifications. I love how it stands. And we have this well-known Expedition Jeep Wrangler. Got some nice left on it, nice wheel, very off-roady. And we got the Rubicon 392. Let's find out what it can do. So now we're gonna be driving around 40 minutes into the desert. Of course, we're gonna have a stop, split the tires, and then we keep going. Gonna show you more, guys. Now let me show you a little bit about the interior of the car. This is a Jeep Wrangler Sport, and we got the Rubicon 392. Having their breakfast. Red Bull in the early morning. Nice sunglasses, my buddy.
1, 2, 3, Viva l'Algérie.
Algeria, with the very sleepy voice. So I'm here with my buddy, Rashid. Have you been ever to the desert? Well, this time you're gonna experience totally different desert. Those guys are crazy, buddy. They drive safe, but they're really crazy. General, when you're driving in desert, it's the driver who really matters. You know, because in desert when you're driving, it's like you're fighting gravity. And if you take the angle wrong or you force gravity in the wrong way, that's a bad. Most important driving desert is safety. So this is what we're gonna do today. So let me tell you something. This guy haven't slept the whole night. No sleeping. Hey buddy, have you been to desert before? Have you been to desert before?
No.
No. First time in Sahara.
First time in desert.
First time in desert. You're gonna love.
So you knew it that we're gonna go far, we're gonna drive far. Why didn't sleep? Let me show them.
This is what we do.
What's happening? Don't get stuck, brother. I believe in you. I'm not a jeeper, by the way. I'm not a jeeper.
The car is great, but I'm not a great driver.
Man, come on. Yes, you are.
I'm being honest.
Believe in yourself. Let's tundra. This is a tundra thing. I like it. We got our wave, tundra wave things.
Yeah, you know?
Look, jeep everywhere. Jeep more jeep. This is what I was trying to say. The jeepers stick together.
Yes, 100%.
Why is that?
Because buying a jeep is more than buying a car. You know, it's buying emotion. You literally connect with the car. And anyone and everyone who buys a Jeep automatically has that bond. This is not only UAE-wide, this is worldwide.
That's why it came from the Jeep wave, I believe.
Absolutely. I mean, it's just a way of showing respect to each other that, you know, I see you. I see you out there.
Sweet, inspiring. I may get the Jeep. Why should I buy a Jeep? Look, I never thought of it. But after the 392, beautiful experience, honestly.
Well, you know, until you do not experience it, you don't know what you're missing out on. I believe that, you know, any car can get you from point A to point B during the course of your life. But if there's something that, you know, which will actually give you true freedom in exploring what is out there in the wild, it's nothing better than the 392.
392, brother. Let's go.
Habibi.
What do you call that?
It's called an Apex Quick Deplete.
Wow, that is awesome. You didn't even use a key or a screwdriver.
It deplates in 5 to 8 seconds.
Wow, that's awesome, man. So, quick tip. How low you go with the tire? How many PSI?
Generally, 8 on the back and 10 on the front.
8 in the back and 10 on the front. Wow, that's pretty low. Woo! Loud though. Is using the technique of pounding. I see those flags all over. But I never understood the real concept for that. Why you put that flags on off-roader?
So the whole point of putting a flag on an off-roader is when you're driving up and down in dunes.
Okay.
When your car drops down a dune.
Okay.
Across the other side of the dune, you see the flag right on top. And that's why it's so much higher than the car. You know that there's a car on the other side of the dune.
So it's not an actual custom thing only, it's a safety thing as well.
It is a safety thing, absolutely. It's not just
awesome, learn guys, you see that? So that's a regulator. Fully charged, which is take the whole pipe. We're gonna inflate the tire. The switch is on.
Just 1 second. We will connect first and then we'll switch on.
Hear the
pssst.
Wow. That thing emptied the tire pretty quickly though.
Yeah, it did. Way too quick.
Yeah. That's my fault though. I was talking too much to you and you missed half a second.
No worries, I got to show you how to fill it up.
Stay safe, hold your equipment, man. Enjoy the ride. Let's find out how it goes. 1 sec. Hey, you tell me everything. You tell me the truth about the Jeep. I'm in love already.
Hey, doesn't need a compass. It finds its own way. It's Jeep.
Man, this guy's Jeep hard. I love it. We start the journey. Here
here is the best stop.
Okay.
It's always side pressing and never fight gravity.
You see
always
that?
Make sure that if you're losing power, come below.
So the key is never fight gravity and go on the side. Guys, write down this.
I see the flag.
Oh ho!
Are you on a tundra, baby?
Yeah! American power!
We made it, guys. We're here. Do you remember when I told you always drive safe? Check this one out. You know, safety when it comes to desert, guy, it's always very important. There is always, if you're not safe, you're not prepared, don't go alone with the desert. Carry a lot of water. It's pretty hot here. All right. Most importantly, don't go alone. Go with people and stay safe. Accidents happen all the time. Okay? Remember, we can't control the environment.
It's pretty hot,
but it's really worth it. Guys, this thing is a beast. This one too. And look this one. That's what I love about the Jeep.
Come on! Oh yeah! Almost there. Watch. There we go.
We played. We had fun. Now it's time for photo shoot. Guys, this is looking amazing. We have to get out here before it hits midday. It's really hot. Hey, any advice for people who's planning to buy a Rubicon?
Take it, enjoy it. Jeep is face of freedom.
Jeep is face of freedom. And imagine with some horsepower, right?
Woo! That's what we're talking about.
Peace up. Thank you, buddy. We made it, guys. Hope you enjoy that with us. And make sure you give us some love, because more love, more content, right?
And more cars, huh?
Is it the TRX or something like that?
You never know, or it could be the new Raptor R.
Raptor R, I'm looking for it. Stay tuned, make sure you subscribe, guys. Guys, and let me know what you think in the comment. Peace. Almost there, 12 midday, boiling hot. You know, those guys are amazing. It was a great experience. What do you think was fun?
Great.
Awesome, we liked it, enjoyed it definitely. How about you?
Guys, yeah,